16 goals en route to a perfect 4-0 start, had many thinking the Leafs were on the road to respectability.
MacArthur scores!
But since then, the offense has dried up, and so have the wins, with only one W in their last 10. That victory coming against their opponents tonight. Leafs, Panthers, next.
Off the boards and out, and there's Christopher Stieg, who has dropped down onto this line. MacArthur for shot, Leafs rebound, and the crew looks up on the ice. Waste of a puck in the face against the Islanders last night, and there's a blast score!
Start, you can't have your third defensive tandem out against the top offensive line for Florida. They broke away from it, and then they went right back to it, and then watched the one-on-one play. It's a great job by Weiss working one-on-one on Gunnarsson, and then Gustafsson's forced to move the puck quicker than he probably would have liked. Brian Allen shoots it through a partial screen. Lebden and Gunnarsson are on the ice, and it's 1-0 Florida. You can't do it when your team's lacking.
That led to a controversial coach's challenge maneuver that Brian Burke didn't like very much.
Yes, he bazooka'd that, didn't he? Here's a chance for the Leafs. Here comes Kolek over the line, and he gets run down by Thomas Hill.
Yannick Dvorak for Marty Reisner,
and a big hit there. Francois Beauchemin. In transition, David Booth with speed. Slowed up by Beauchemin, and Thomas Hill comes across to claim the puck. Good play by Beauchemin, and then MacArthur got hit with that pass. Turned over chance. Big stop, Gustafsson. Off David Boone McCabe, and he bounces off a check, centers it, but MacArthur all kinds of time. Bakuma stop, loose in the crease, and Stephen Weiss there to help out. And the puck is frozen. Clark MacArthur, who's had the best lead chances tonight.
Keaton Ellerbe wears number 4 for the Florida Panthers. Rob Blake used to wear number 4 when he played in the NHL too. And for Keaton Ellerbe, he tries to get a little too aggressive. It leads to an end zone breakdown and chance for Clark MacArthur right down low, but all that breakdown was because Keaton Ellerbe left his feet leading with his derriere, and it forced Thomas Vokunin some good saves and eventually freezing it in his own crease.
To the line, and there's Olich handing it off to the speedy Santarelli. Over the line, Santarelli, a shot, rebound, and Gustafsson, two big stops. Across it goes, Weidman stopped by Gustafsson, rebound, right back, scores.
We can only stop so many opportunities. Steven Reinprecht with a great pass through the legs early on in the sequence. Michael Frolik walks the line. Eventually the puck's gonna carry him off of Jonas Gustafsson off the shot by Dennis Weidman, and Steven Reinprecht will capitalize. There's only so much you can do in that situation, Chris. And Gustafsson held up his end of the bargain. The Leaf penalty killers didn't hold up theirs.
And that's Florida. And here's Santarelli with a lane to the net. Santarelli able, he just couldn't tuck it as he got by Gustafsson. Here's a break. Sean Matthias right in on goal. Scores! Breakaway goal for Sean Matthias, his third of the year. And it's 3-0 Panthers.
Again, trying to do too much. Brett Lebda, number 23, playing with Luke Shen. Johnny Mitchell's going to get the puck in deep. Here's Brett Lebda trying to force the offense in. He's stuck below the icing line. Where's the forward to support him? There isn't any, so Luke Shen gets hung out to dry. Great play on the wall. And Sean Matthias right through the wickets on Jonas Gustafsson, making it 3-0. But if you're going to have a defenseman go in like that, the Leafs have to be aware. That's why Lebda's on the ice right now. The forward has to be back.
They're changing behind Bozak. Off the skate to Booth as he goes to the bench. Reisner, ridden hard into the boards, right in front of the Leafs. Bernier Kraus and a bouncing puck, and Olesch couldn't get a shot away. Thomas Eric steps up. Mike Thomas Eric and Weidman and him collide on an offside, and that was a pretty good collision with the whistle already sounded.
It doesn't get any easier for Toronto. They go home and play Vancouver, a fast, physical team.
And if you're a Toronto Maple Leaf player, you better get ready for a whole lot of that from Vancouver.
And this skid early this season, just as painful. Here's Foligno, scores! Michael Foligno, short side. And Florida has another power play goal and a 4-0 lead.
You win battles, you win races, and then you make the opposition pay. Now, this is just a nice job by the Florida Panthers. Little battle on the wall, you win it, keep the play alive, and what a feed right over to Matthias. Backhand feed over to Frolik, and he just snapped it right by Gustafson. So that's Steven Reinprecht making a good decision, Sean Matthias making a good decision, and you get a little taste of Michael Frolik, the former Rimouski Oceanic. He just nails that thing right by. They really wanted Bertuzzi for their playoff run. It worked out well for them. But for the Florida Panthers at that time, it was a real good decision to go out and get the former Belleville Bull, Sean Matthias. He's going to be a great player.
Here's a pass, a chance, and the drought is over for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Mikhail Grabowski, with 6:35 to go, breaks up the Vokoun shadow bid. And something to cheer for Leaf fans here in Sunrise.
Well, you build off the positives. There's no question. And this is something that works out well. They lose the draw, which has been happening a lot, but it's good pursuit and forechecking by Christopher Stieg and also by Clark MacArthur. They don't quit on the play, and Grabowski does what he's supposed to do. He goes right into the slot, takes the relay from behind the icing line, and makes it 4-1.